Hey everyone, as a lot of you know, Hidden Item actually had the opportunity to check out this year's E3, and at E3 was Kingdom Hearts 3, and I actually had the opportunity to play it. And I've got a lot to say about it, but I just wanted to focus on the negatives. I feel like the positives have been mostly said, and I don't know if there's much I can add to that. The game's gorgeous, but I just wanted to make a video focusing on the negatives because I feel like it needs to be said in order for any improvements to come later on. I mean, even if we're just small, you know, I want to get them out there. And I also want to inform people just exactly what they're getting into. Disclaimer, I love the demo as a whole, and I honestly cannot wait for it. But I just want to focus on the bad stuff, and that's what this video is going to be. To start this off, we've got the camera. Now, camera control has never really been a positive experience in any of the Kingdom Hearts games. It started off terribly in Kingdom Hearts 1, and only showed marginal improvements from that point forward. And I'm sorry to say that Kingdom Hearts 3 is no different from this. For instance, take a look at this boss fight with the Rock Titan. Starting off this fight underneath the massive Titan creates an uncomfortable situation where you just don't know what to do with the camera because it bumps into the enemy no matter which way you position it. It's kinda like realizing that your tongue is not comfortable no matter where in your mouth you place it. It's just unpleasant. Secondly, as the fight progressed, I entered a second phase where Sora must use flow motion to reach the top of the Titan. This was more difficult to do than it should have been because of the odd way the camera pans up. You have no idea which way to angle the stick because of where the camera is positioned and how the camera rotates, which actually caused me to fail on my first attempt, and even my second attempt is very jarring to say the least. Now, the part that showcased just how poor the camera was during this part of the demo was when I activated Ars Arcanum. The moment I hit triangle to activate the move, the imaginary cameraman that I always imagined behind the scenes in these games must have started having a stroke, because no matter how hard I tried to fight this awkward position, the camera just would not budge from this location. Even trying to lock on and off didn't reorient the camera. This is one of the worst instances of bad camera control that I've ever experienced in a Kingdom Hearts game, and it honestly sucks to know that they really haven't come a long way with improving it since the first entry. Moving on from the camera, we have the wall running. Being able to run up walls is a great idea as it offers plenty of exploration opportunities and some potentially awesome world designs, but unfortunately it's weighed down by a frankly janky control scheme that made it awkward for Sora to move or even stop where he wanted to. Seeing footage for this mechanic in the past led me to believe that moving left and right was controlled with the L1 and R1 buttons, which to me would have actually made a lot of sense, but instead they mapped all movement to just the control stick. This was a problem as the wall running felt overly stiff if you wanted to move left and right while maintaining your upward sprint. Lean a little too much to one side and Sora is sent running off in a direction you don't want. Next up, the physics. Now let's cut right to the word floaty. To me, floatiness is coupled together with the idea of weightless and slow attacks. You can forget about the slow attacks because this game is fast, make no mistake. However, the weightlessness of the combat is something to be concerned about. Too many times during this demo did I go for an attack that should have been a sure thing and in the end, I missed. And as a veteran of the series that has been there since the beginning and went on to platinum the entire series, this shouldn't happen. Just about every combo I attempted wouldn't connect. It seems the game is more concerned about having overly flashy moves that attack in a wide arc instead of a more focused combat system seen in Kingdom Hearts 1 and 2, which is a real shame. It is worth noting that this problem seemed to stem mostly from the Keyblade transformations as opposed to the base Keyblade form, which felt a lot better for the most part. Now, I want to talk about the size of enemies in relation to the size of the world. The enemies are too fucking small. That's really about it though. During the demo, I found myself looking for enemies a few times that were hidden among the many details of the world. This is really the only double-edged sword I came across. It's the price to be paid to have worlds as big and gorgeous as these are. Lastly, I want to shed some light on the lock-on system. So if you played one Kingdom Hearts game, you understand its lock-on system as it has remained mostly unchanged since the beginning. Now that being said, Kingdom Hearts 3 has the worst lock-on system in the series. Normally in a Kingdom Hearts game, once you finish an enemy, the camera would swing around as it locks onto the next enemy that's closest to you, and that worked great for me. In this one, however, the game wouldn't do that. It would just act as if there were no enemy near you, and even hitting the R1 button didn't cause a blue lock-on symbol to show up. This happened multiple times in the demo, even when just staring at an enemy, but honestly, I see this as an issue that will most likely be sorted out by the game's release. And that's about all I've got to say right now, and like I said at the beginning of the video, I loved the demo more than I hated it. I just wanted to let you guys know, hey, these are the issues with Kingdom Hearts 3, and this is what you should expect, or hopefully this is stuff that could be fixed upon later on. I do expect some of the stuff to be fixed upon, some more than others, but you know, we'll see how that goes. But if you like this video, give us a like, give us a comment. Let us know what we could do to do better. Let us know if you, you know, agree with any of this, if you actually had the chance to try it out already. And yeah, I'm Ricky, and I got nothing else to say. I'll catch you guys next time. See ya.